Good morning, YouTube family. When you're watching this, it's Sunday morning. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers literally around the world watching this daily vlog. Thank you for being here. I hope you have a great day. Rest up. Make other people get you everything. Treat yourself. Treat yourself. All right. I'm going to treat myself to some coffee, if you know what I mean. Oh, man. Happy Mother's Day 2019. Oh, yeah. With nothing to miss, ain't no thought about time. In my mind, doing just fine. Taking me deep. Time to get organized. It's summertime, pulling out the summer stuff. Time to get organized. Look at it. It's a little crazy, but we got this. We got this. All right. Just working on the boys' new fort. If you've been watching the vlog for a long, long time, you know that this is a brand new addition to our backyard. It's pretty epic. I will give you the full view here in a second. Oh man, nothing like a good fort as a kid, right? And frankly, as an adult as well. All right, putting on the, what is that called? The steering wheel for the ship. So this is the boys' new fort. I had a big fort growing up, loved it, lived in it basically. And it was time to get you guys a place to hang out all summer, right? Yeah, Josh is excited. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah. So, good times here in Denver, Colorado. Oh man, it's pretty epic. So it's got the first level, second level. There's that, we just put, we call it the crow's nest, way up there, so. Boom. Off to the gym. Here we go. Oh, and back we are. Back we are in the studio. I think the last clip that I filmed earlier today, I said that I was going to the gym. And you're probably like, hey, where's the footage from the gym? I did go, I promise. But yes, there are some situations in filming the daily vlog that do pop up. Thankfully, there's not that many overhead expenses when filming, editing a daily video and uploading it to YouTube. That's the beauty of new technology. Like, we couldn't do this, you know, 10 years ago, it would be much more difficult, and 15 years ago, it wouldn't even be possible. So, anyway, I'm grateful for GoPro technology, but sometimes it says enough is enough, and this would not turn on today. The GoPro 7, not sure what's going on. I'll try to take it into Best Buy tomorrow to see if they can help me out a little bit, see if something's going on that they can figure out, but it did not turn on today. So I do have some money saved up, so that's good. So I think I can replace it sooner rather than later. But these things happen in life, don't they? Oh my goodness, don't they? And that's what we're gonna reflect on today, the injury and getting to the bottom of why I think this injury happened. Now listen, unless it's a traumatic injury, there's a good chance that you will never know what actually caused your injury. Now, we can make a lot of good guesses. Overuse is the common term thrown around in the running world, an overuse injury. And yes, I'm basically putting this injury into the overuse category. What does that mean? Basically, I probably ran too much, or more likely, actually, in my case, too much at too high of intensity, meaning too fast of miles or kilometers. Now, before I reflect, and yes, keyword reflect, before I reflect with all of you on why I think this injury popped up in this training cycle and what shoe or shoes may have added to the possibility of this injury happening, I want to remind everyone what I'm actually trying to fight for and pull off in the next 9 months. And it's kind of it's not going to be easy. And it just got a little more difficult because of this injury. Okay. I am not a state champ from high school. I think my highest finish was second place or third place in the 2 mile. I think I was third place in the 2 mile. Not bad, but I was never a state champ. That was my brother. He cleaned house in high school. And then in college, I was never an All-American. Like, I did okay, but I was never an All-American. And so fast forward to, let's say 4 years ago, so 2015, basically I became an ultra runner. So longer races, 30-mile races, 50-mile races, 100-mile races, which, what does that mean? You're running slower. So I actually wrote down some splits here. Races between 7 to 10 minutes a mile, depending on the distance, and which is 420 per kilometer, 420 to 615 per kilometer, so much slower paces compared to what I'm trying to do now. And yes, even 9 months ago, it's crazy, 8 to 9 months ago, I was trying to finish a 100-mile race. And in that process of training for a 100-mile race, actually going out and racing with plantar fasciitis, it didn't feel good. You see my tears there on the screen. Like, it was an intense moment. Yes, if you wanna go watch it, it's a good vlog. But I was trying to pull off something that was probably a little too early in my running career. I'm not giving up on 100-mile races, just so you know. Like, I'd like to race many down the road. I'm honestly thinking early 40s, so 7-8 years from now. And so then after about a month and a half later, I did a half marathon time trial. Many of you have seen this footage that you're looking at on your screen. I ran basically 1 hour and 11 minutes flat here at elevation, solo, on kind of a rolly course, 1 hour and 11 minutes, and I was running 40 to 50 miles a week. And that woke me up. I thought to myself, huh, that's a pretty fast time at elevation solo. I wonder what I could do at sea level in a competitive environment. And so over the past 3 to 4 years, it's been slower racing, 7, 8, 9 minutes per mile in a race. I know, it's like, that's what ultra running is, especially at elevation on hilly courses. And now I'm going through this kind of a dramatic shift in a fairly short amount of time as I attempt to chase down this 2:19 marathon. And because of that, I knew last, you know, December and early January 2019 that I needed to make a change in my training so that I could drop from the 7 minutes a mile down to 5:18 per mile. And I know I can do it, but I gotta stay healthy, right? And I need to walk that line and probably back off that line now in retrospect, back off that line on the threshold runs and the tempo runs as I'm chasing down this 5:18 per mile pace that I need to get to. And so I can pinpoint April 3rd, my first tempo run, 15 miles, 6 minutes per mile, or 3:45 per kilometer. I know it's fast. I was feeling good that day, but that was the run. I looked it up on Strava. That was the run where I felt a small little something in my big toe, a little twinge, nothing sharp, just a little twinge. And you guys know those little twinges and those little niggles can turn into something big. Well, sure enough, I'm blaming that run as the beginning of this injury. Now, in retrospect, I should have taken 2 or 3 days off, 4 days off, and monitored it. I didn't think it was a big deal, but sure enough, it turned into a bigger deal than I expected. And yes, I'm gonna blame myself. I'm not blaming a shoe. I'm blaming myself for putting too many miles in this shoe that I'm about to show you. I lost track of how many miles I had put into this shoe. And you know how I like to put 50 miles into a shoe before I give you my full review? So that's what I was doing. And frankly, guys, at the end of that 15-mile tempo run, I was wearing this shoe and I lost track. Instead of 50, I had put 99 miles. I feel a little dumb now. It just proves, like, make sure you're tracking your miles on your shoes. And yes, guys, The shoe that I'm about to show you, it's not a training shoe. I should not have put this many miles in the shoe. It's a racing shoe. You could do tempo work in it if you wanted. And listen, I still like the shoe a lot, but I should have only put 50 miles at the most and more like probably 20 to 30. So, yeah, it is the Adidas Adi Zero Adios 4. Again, I like the shoe a lot, but this shoe does not have enough midsole through the entire shoe, but especially the forefoot. And so I'm blaming myself for losing track of the miles, but I just want you to know, I'm also blaming the fact that I don't think this shoe has enough cushion to use it as a regular trainer. And I knew that, but I wanted to get 50 miles in for you. And then I look on Strava and I'm like, oh, I put 99 miles in the shoe. And so c'est la vie, what are you gonna do? I feel a little dumb, but this is life. And like I mentioned at the beginning, I'm not just blaming one shoe or just that tempo run. It's an accumulation of overuse that leads to injuries in runners. And preventative measures, should have spent a little more time on dirt, should have spent now. I'm excited for cross training moving, and gosh, glass half full, who knows? Long term, maybe this is what I needed to light a fire in my cross training desire. Like just to get into that pool more often, to get onto the cross training bike more often. I'm excited now. So once I'm healthy and back to running, you better believe I'm gonna continue to do cross training. I don't know how much, I gotta find that balance as well. But, and then also just a little bit more cushion through the midsole on longer runs and or tempo runs. Now listen, I remember the Vomero 14 not working out for me, and that was gonna be my long run shoe in 2019, so who knows? I don't know, maybe if I would have stuck to the Vomero 14 more so this spring, maybe I could have prevented this, I don't know. Now I have received some messages and I've read some comments here on YouTube saying that minimalist shoes versus maximalist shoes, that's not what I need to be focused on. I need to be focused on strengthening my feet. And you remember, I was doing foot strengthening exercises all winter. I filmed it quite a bit for you guys because I knew I needed to take care of my feet and make sure my feet stayed healthy. Well, in retrospect, probably should have done more of that, but we're not gonna have that debate now between maximalist shoes, so like Hoka shoes, and minimalist shoes, but I will give you my thoughts very, very soon on that topic because it's a very good one to discuss. I definitely have my opinions as far as staying healthy and I'm not gonna get into it now. We will get into that very soon. Okay, again, reflect is the key word and the question of the day. I don't wanna focus on the negative and injuries. I wanna focus on the positive. I wanna hear, how was your long run this weekend, or how was your race this weekend? Because I know a lot of you race this weekend. Let us know where the race was, what distance you ran, and what time you hit. I'd love to congratulate you and just give you a digital high five here on YouTube. Keep it positive. That's what we're all about. And tomorrow I will give you an update on my foot. All right, does that sound good? How it's feeling, how it's progressing, etc., etc. Thank you for being here. It was a fun day organizing at the house and just enjoying the weekend and trying to relax, trying to chill out, trying to enjoy this moment where I'm not running and just let the body heal. Let it heal. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.